I'm biting his fingers.
You've seemed a bit off lately. What's going on?
It's just some family stuff. I don't really want to get into it.
Dealing with that is sometimes way harder than anything you face in the ring.
I hear you. Hey, actually, I need a partner for a tag match. Would you be willing to team up with me? Might be a good way to get my mind off of everything.
Yeah, I guess I
can. Gracias.
I don't think we need much of a strategy. Just let me do my thing, and I'll make sure we get the win.
That's not really being a team.
Well, this might just be a one-time thing for me. We'll see.
I get to unlock the Mexico arena.
This is gonna be good.
Dude, why is it showing the Undertaker stuff?
It's a tag team match scheduled for one fall on the way to the ring at a combined weight of 427 pounds. Chris Bannon and Hector Flores.
As a pro athlete, he just began to reach his potential in football when nagging injuries caught up to him. After he.
How do you lock him in a submission?
I'm not entirely sure.
Saudi Arabia, a man who is the winner of the biggest battle royal in WWE.
This has a swerve.
It swerves.
Yeah, it is.
Does that make you, Saxton, like the annoying neighbor who called the cops when the music's too loud?
That's not a very nice thing to say.
From Tacoma, Washington.
I won by KO.
Working on the arm, he's feeling the effects of that last hit. Him and Soar reverses it. Reversal. Can he take advantage? These two showing how well scouted they each are. Got a good up. All the way.
Fuck.
Reversal. Can they go on the attack? He is
delivering elbow after elbow.
Placing them right where they want them, into the corner. Mansoor is brought to a disadvantage now.
Yeah, Mansoor has to weather the storm here.
Bang! Drop kick.
Here we go.
A slingshot cross body.
That is tossing your own body around without a care. Taking no account for your own well-being.
Two.
Got him where he wants. Gets stonewalled.
Four.
Oh, across the top rope.
No way.
Six.
Oh, God.
A totally ill-advised decision there.
Maybe slight hesitation there caused the outcome.
He went right into that turnbuckle.
There's a tag.
Magic killer!
Too sweet.
The end is, here he goes for the win.
One, two,
it up. And the match continues. Oh, no, 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 no.
Spiked into the ring apron.
Sentiment, but now is not the time to bask in disbelief.
Mansoor escapes the attack.
Executed arm drag.
Are you still in the performance center? Oh no, you said you were on SmackDown.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-oh.
Face first.
Oh man.
He takes control. Set up in the corner of the ring.
Here's a tag.
Opponent off the ropes.
He made the tag. Cooking with gas now. Once more, setting it up.
Swerve is down and out.
Judo throw. I don't know what you call that, but it hurt.
What a hot shot. Sent all the way to the outside.
He's got to know he's in harm's way here.
Shining wizard.
A game-ending move. Checkmate.
I changed my finishers. I'm no longer using the spear. I'm using the last shot now. I might switch out my twisting TKO, but I kind of like it.
I know we got the win out there tonight, but I apologize. I was definitely not on top of my game.
I could tell. I know you said you didn't want to talk about your family stuff, but what the heck is going on?
All right. You have to promise not to tell anyone else about it. Deal?
Yeah, I promise.
So my father has been in touch with me lately.
I thought you were on speaking terms.
We weren't, but since I made it to NXT, he's been contacting me all the time.
So why is that a bad thing?
Because I haven't been honest with you or anyone else about my background or who my dad is. The truth is, I do come from a famous Mexican wrestling family. My father is El Mago Sr.
Wait, I'm confused. What about that wrestler El Mago Jr.? Is he your brother? And why hide all this in the first place?
Let me explain. When I first decided to get into wrestling, I wanted to carry on my father's name and become El Mago Jr. But my dad didn't think I had what it took to make it and decided to sell the name to the guy who's now El Mago Jr. It really hurt that he put his faith in some stranger instead of his own son. Ever since then, I've been determined to make it on my own without my father's help or namesake.
Wow. Well, I guess that explains why you wanted nothing to do with his retirement show a while back.
Exactly. And that was fine just doing my own thing, but now that I've had some success and made it to NXT, my father suddenly wants me to be El Mago Jr.
Interesting timing.
Yeah. And worse, he's even convinced NXT management it's a good idea. This is the last thing I ever wanted. My father should have no part of my success when he never once believed in me before this.
I get why all that's bothering you, but I'm sure everything will work itself out.
I hope you're right.
And don't worry. Your secret is safe with me.
You requested this interview because you said you had some life-changing information that you needed to share with the world. This is your chance to tell us. What do you want to get off your chest?
First of all, what I'm about to reveal isn't going to change my life. It's going to change the life of Hector Flores. For the better. Full disclosure, this is a secret Hector made me promise to keep. But I'm doing this to help him. I can't let him continue to hide from the truth, because it's bringing him down. And that truth is he is the son of Mexican lucha libre legend El Mago. But why was this a secret to begin with? It wasn't because Hector chose to create his own identity as some kind of noble self-reliant act. No, he was forced to because his own father was ashamed of him and didn't want his real son following in his footsteps. He was so certain Hector would never make it that he sold off his lineage, the El Mago Jr. name, to the highest bidder on the indie scene. So, I'm not doing this to hurt Hector Flores. That damage has already been done by his father. I'm doing this to liberate him from his past. He no longer has to hide from the truth and silently let it tear him apart. You're free now, Hector. You're welcome.
The WWE Universe is still reeling from that bombshell he dropped moments ago.
Hector Flores must have heard what his so-called friend said and is clearly upset.
This is a no disqualification match. Anything someone can dream up to do to their opponent is legal. Take the rules and throw them out the window.
Well, this allows a superstar to pursue victory by any means necessary. And some experience a state of twisted ecstasy while punishing their adversary.
We are witnessing an environment where competitors can embrace their anger and aggressive instincts because it's all legal.
I'm glad you're done believing in fairy tales, Saxton. The hero doesn't always win. Sometimes you have to embrace the darkness.
Stomping, ouch.
Oh, man.
Vice-like grip on the throat, up and down with a choke slam.
An agile escape. Clothesline.
Oh, he knew what was coming.
Yeah.
Reversal after reversal. These two are ready for each other.
He's able to fend off the attack.
Setting it up. Thunderous clothesline. The tables. Kick to the gut. Makes him pay with a counter. And this might not have a
through the table. Through the table.
Setting up.
Caught with a.
And that will do it.
Here comes trouble.
The following contest is a tag team match scheduled for one fall on the way to the ring.
What the fuck?
At a combined weight of 410 pounds, Chris Bannon and El Mago Jr.
We're seeing an athlete.
Aaron, are you there?
Mm-hmm.
You're really quiet.
It's the luchador sensation, Andrew Flores.
Weighing in at 202 pounds, Hector Flores.
We're looking at some of the most intense competitors in all of WWE, about to take part in one of the most anticipated matches ever. Sun team of Hector Flores and El Mago Sr. taking on the imposter El Mago Jr. and the man who Hector thought was his friend.
Hector believed he could trust him with a family secret, but that obviously wasn't the case.
You ask me, did Hector a favor by exposing El Mago Sr. for the terrible person that he is? But clearly, Hector was too short-sighted to see that, and well, here we are.
Just turn that around.
Man, hungry.
Go make yourself some food.
He switches it back around.
I'm not that hungry.
So then don't go make yourself some food.
Really just laying it in.
Here comes Corbin.
Which Corbin?
King Corbin.
Oh yeah, you're on SmackDown, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, see, I'm on NXT, so I'll probably see Dominik Dijakovic and shit.
Tag is made.
Error there.
Seth crashing to the floor.
Next year we'll probably get the new stuff. If I think if Pat McAfee is, I think if Pat is still around and Jimmy's still around, they might put them in the game, maybe.
Who's Jimmy?
The Raw announcer.
Oh, sorry. I thought you were talking about someone else. Flores is getting
beaten down. Yeah, Umago is really remaining the aggressor here. Able to get the advantage here. Yeah, he's able to stop that surge dead in its tracks. So much damage inflicted. Right back in. Side slam. Ooh. And now Flores is getting beaten down.
Flores has run into a roadblock.
Big boot to the guts. He's in a little bit of trouble now. Yeah, they stuck it out through this match, but it wouldn't hurt to go for the tag soon here.
Mago Jr. Come on, Aaron, watch me.
Oh, I can't right now.
Oh, it was part of the song. See what I can find in the pool hall. Talk to Robin.
Ugh, Cameron Grimes has been leaving one-star reviews on my podcast ever since I criticized one of his matches.
I even caught Cameron in the act when he was in catering, using the very stealthy username Grimes Rules. Can you knock some sense into him? I'm just trying to do my job.
No, I'm not going to be a face.
Why don't you want to be a face?
Because I want to keep being a heel.
Okay, so this is crazy, but I promised myself that if I ran into...
No. I don't want to be face. I want to stay heel.
What are you doing here? Did you get signed to NXT?
No, not yet. But I hope that changes after tonight. I have a non-televised match to show management what they're missing out on. And I was hoping I could face you.
Okay, I'll do it.
Great. So, how do we want to approach this?
Simple. We go out there, and I show everyone that you're not ready for NXT.
What about helping me get a job?
If you want a spot here, you're gonna have to earn it. And that's not gonna happen against me.
Aw, come on, man. We go way back. I thought you'd be willing to work with me on this.
I'm offended you'd even suggest that. So now, I'm not just gonna beat you. I'm gonna make an example out of you.
Is it too late to face someone else?
Yes. See you in the ring.
Damn, I'm about to make this guy fucking crumble. I feel bad for Chase.
We all wanna go big, then say that. Ho! Yeah, boy, we doing big things, big belts, big rings, bigger than you ever seen.
This could be a big win.
Thank you.
I just murdered Chase. Bloodbath. Oh, Rigo's trying to get me to turn face. No thanks. I might actually need to turn face to continue my story. I'd rather do as much heal stuff as I can before I turn.
If you haven't already heard, the NXT Breakout Tournament is right around the corner. This year, it's open to NXT and NXT UK superstars who've never received an NXT title opportunity, which means you're eligible.
What does the winner get?
Confident one, are we? The winner will earn a championship match of their choice at NXT TakeOver.
I think I'd rather earn a championship opportunity.
It's your career.
I know you already have a match tonight, but I'm desperate. Some WWE execs are coming from LA, but their flight is delayed.
No, I don't want to turn face. Fuck off. All right, that's it. Alright, I'm going for the NXT North American Championship, I guess.
Now I've been looking forward to this one.
Who's this? Oh, it's Timothy Thatcher.
No, time for a grappling lesson. Well, this is more than a lesson, Cole. This is a master class.
Oh, Dominik Dijakovic.
Timothy Thatcher and Dominik Dijakovic.
Their opponent will need to dig deep to beat two NXT studs of their caliber.
The springboard attack fails to land. And Thatcher gets stonewalled.
Bruh.
Got him set up in the corner of the ring. Face full of turnbuckle. Choke slam backbreaker. Choke bomb.
it was just malicious. Insulting. Oh, what a counter. Ooh, oh, strong kick. My goodness. Oh, right to the kidneys.
Oh, no. Now that he has the kendo stick, I definitely do not want to be in his path of destruction.
Now he's been put on the defensive. In triple threats, the damage comes twice as fast. He knew that coming in. He's turning the tables. Well placed kick to the gut. Another damaging kick. Turns to the ring. STO! And an overbearing amount of offense against Dijakovic here.
Dijakovic in desperate need of turning things around.
He's getting a little battered now. Judo throw. Oh, cutter! Both wrists captured. That was nasty.
Dijakovic out of harm's way. What's Dijakovic thinking?
Did you just steal my finish?
He is feeling it now.
And he stops the count.
Some agility.
Closed fist connects. Reciprocating the initial reversal. He avoids the damage. Series of reversals. Clothesline!
Nasty kick to the face.
No!
Slingshot cross body? That was ridiculous.
Just a devil may care attitude on full display.
Going for broke and it pays off.
He's headed up top.
Thinking big.
From way up, moved out of the way. Nobody home. Shining wizard. Will that keep Thatcher Brown? Oh, looking close line. Hoping to end it here. This is it. 1, 2. And a kick out again. This is incredible.
Every kick out taking so much energy to muster.
Makes the cover. 2, 3.
And gets the win, beating the odds in this triple threat.
Here is your winner, Chris Bannon.
Last week, you earned the opportunity to face Damian Priest for his North American Championship. However, after the match, Priest announced a $50,000 bounty for anyone who could successfully take you out. How have you been dealing with this situation?
Look,
It's clear that Damian Priest knows he can't beat me. So this was the only solution he could come up with to hold on to his championship. But it's not going to work. So far, no one's even attempted to cash in on the bounty. And that tells me that just like Priest, the rest of the NXT locker room wants no part of me. So it's been business as usual. If anyone does want to try to cash in, I'll consider it a warm-up for Priest. And if not, I'm ready either way.
Roderick, you really want a piece of me?
And this has turned into a brawl. Forget about any match. This is a street fight. Oh, foot just stomping down. Oh, red in there. He moves just in time. And it's reverse pain for that mistake. Oh! 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 Dodged right on cue. Whoa, not quite yet. Paying it back with their own counter. Vice-like grip on the throat, up and... sit out, choke slam. Strikes with a kick. Oh, that might have just broken something. Setting it up. Thunderous clothesline. The body with the chair. Impressive defense from Strong. Dodges the attack just a smidge quicker. He's reminding his competition that they'll only ever be second best. Uh-oh, table in the ring. I don't like what we're about to see. German suplex! Ooh! Yeah. Oh, what impact! Strong avoids damage. Catches the leg. He's returning fire. Able to reverse that one. The adrenaline is pumping, and the WWE Universe is on his side. Overhand right lands. Caught the leg. Leg caught. Look out. Exploder suplex. Such impact. Oh, knee drop. Woo. I can't begin to imagine what he's got planned here, guys.
Maybe it's a yard sale.
Oh, this ends right here. He's got him on the hole, Mike!
That's it.
wonder what happens when I win a title. How is this going to work? Am I just not going to win it, or am I just going to be stuck defending it until I lose it? Like, here comes the pain, or...
Santos Escobar from behind. Escobar's looking to cash in on Damian Priest's bounty.
This guy can't catch a break.
What are you expecting from this superstar tonight, guys?
Well, he did say earlier that he's going to attack his opponent with a renewed hostility that we've never seen before.
Yeah, he also said he's going to make the competition beg for mercy.
And facing him is Santos Escobar, one of the more controversial superstars today. Escobar is obsessed with the legacy of Lucha Libre, but wants to create one on his own terms. No mask, all results.
Escobar's creating a new, modern tradition, one win at a time. As far as he's concerned, he doesn't need to wear a mask to properly honor his ancestors. Escobar showing no fear up there. Sky high. Oh, and he doesn't connect.
These knee strikes.
Ooh. Santos falling victim to an onrush now.
This can't be how Santos envisioned tonight going.
What a striking combination. Down you go. He's positioning himself, closing in on the middle rope.
I wonder if we're gonna see Paragon in a couple years, like as a something.
You mean as a something?
Yeah, you know how we had Baron Blade?
Oh, maybe.
Remember Baron Blade? What was he, a wrestler, right?
Yeah, wrestler, then manager, like general manager. Yeah, I guess it's possible.
Escobar avoids that one. Santos counters.
And Escobar isn't looking helpless anymore.
Yeah, his instincts are taking over. He's getting pushed out into the defensive. Well, all things considered, Cole, it's not a bad condition to be in at this point in the match. That's gotta be it. There's two. Oh, got the shoulder up just.
I play as the women because you can't hit the girl, you know? But when you play as a woman, you can hit the guy, so like I can like prevent them from like breaking it up.
There he goes, right into the corner. Oh, target in the eye.
I just don't bother. I just play the match and try to be careful.
Iris Gary up there with a deal. Shining wizard. Escobar's completely out of it. Two. And now let's do it, folks. Here is your winner, Chris Bannon.
And with the result. I haven't had too many mixed tag matches, though. I think I've only had one. I'm curious to see if the mixed match challenge is in this. I'm assuming so.
Yeah, I'm in it right now.
Oh, really? Oh, that's cool. Who's your partner?
Naomi.
Oh. Am I about to go into a handicap match? For real?
Handicap matches are not hard if they're tagging. If it's Tornado, they might be hard, but... I think I've mastered the game enough to where I can... to where I can up the difficulty.
And now these bounty hunters look to take out Priest's upcoming opponent and split the hefty haul amongst themselves.
On the other hand, there's nothing like winning a difficult match like this to send a message to the NXT North American champion that you're still coming for his title. He saw it coming, taking advantage.
This is going to be hard.
Take a good look at a real-life titan, folks. Oh, that'll break his arm. Vicious. Able to interrupt the attack. Boom, right to the shot. Oh, you can pick up your deep in section 112. That could bring an end to Birch.
Gets him with the what? He just hit me. He just hit me and he didn't get disqualified. I think I know why. Because you know the move that Samoa Joe does on the apron whenever they you get hit and then he falls and then he does the he comes back with his enziguri kind of thing?
Yeah.
He hit me, but I guess the game sees it as me doing the move. So I guess it didn't disqualify him. Even though he hit a woman.
Up in the neck area have gone
shining wizard. The big gun fired yet again.
Just punched him right in the mouth. Relentless. Ooh, my phone's buzzing. This time it can only either mean one thing, is either Joshua or the wrestling guy that I talked to.
Dude, how come I can't ask these guys out? What the fuck?
And it's Joshua. Guess who I'm facing? Asuka and Shinsuke.
That's a cool team.
Of course they would put them together.
He'll take things into the ring. And he's able to fight off Larkin.
Really working that.
The official. We're going to free the arm and does just that.
I need to catch up on Marvel, because Doctor Strange coming up pretty soon. I really wish that Shinsuke had the beginning of his song, you know?
What do you mean?
The dun 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 dun. It's not even. It's not in the game.
That's because it's what a heel theme. Maybe if we're lucky, maybe the Boogs won. Oh. No DQ match, this will be fun. Have you won a title yet?
I'm in the Mixed Match Challenge. No. I haven't lost, though, since I changed the difficulty.
Neither have I. I've only lost once.
And they barely even touched me, like, at all. I won.
From the underground of New York City, Damian Priest.
the genuine article, living the best rock star life. Champagne, jacuzzis, beautiful ladies on each arm. This dude is the real deal. And all business in the ring. Born and raised in the concrete jungle of New York City, Damian Priest lives to throw hands. Damian Priest has this unchecked rage, ready to attack at will. He'll shut you down. And in the end, he...
Introducing the challenger from Orlando, Florida, weighing in at 225 pounds, Chris Bannon. And introducing the champion from New York, New York, weighing in at 249 pounds. He is the NXT North American Champion, Damian Priest.
Here we go. This is what it's all about. The NXT North American Championship is on the line. Damian Priest's opponent has been unstoppable ever since Priest placed a bounty on his head. And I don't see that challenger slowing down tonight.
It's been mo money, mo problems for Priest, and now he has to face the monster of his own making in a no DQ match for the NXT North American Championship.
Cole, did you just quote rap lyrics? If that's any indication of how wild tonight's gonna get, you are in for a treat, ladies and gentlemen.
A rolling cutter!
Both wrists captured and
right on the arm. Oh, the reversal by Priest.
Biting his I'm biting his fingers.
Oh, I was like, what's up with the noise effects? Shit.
Firm control.
Priest, top turnbuckle.
You know what, guys? I was afraid it was going to get to this point. Top rope! Superplex!
The champ now absorbing a little damage.
Yeah, but he's not breathing heavy yet.
Absolutely no telling what's underneath the ring tonight.
And now with the kendo stick in hand, he's ready to do some real damage.
Could cause irreparable damage, but I don't think you can come back from this many.
And Priest is being controlled here.
This is where that calm of Priest will be tested.
No, grab the kendo stick.
Oh! Priest tied that.
He's got the target acquired. Just a matter of moments. A kendo stick wrapped around the head.
Judo throws by cutter.
Ooh, well measured.
And now he's really falling behind. Yeah, and every attempt to fight back's being negated. Each.
Carefully placed stomp to the arm.
Oh, right to the kidneys.
Golly.
The challenger's looking shaken. And he's able to fight.
Shining wizard. We could have a new champion.
One, two. He kicked out at two.
That was a matter of a fraction of a second.
That move has brought victory before, but not on this occasion. Might be time to think outside the box.
Come on.
I am in shock. What's it
That's
gonna
it.
Take
We're
to
ending
keep
this the right
down?
Way.
And a kick.
Priest able to avoid that.
Scary pattern starting to form.
We're finishing this. It's
damage.
Over.
Looking to end this.
New North American champion.
The following contest is...
Yeah, now we're talking.
Of course, the title is on the line in this one, guys.
And don't be surprised if history is made here tonight. I know the champ has looked good as of late, but I'd say the opposition has looked just as good, if not better.
So here's my opponent. Who am I defending against? Someone from Mustache Mountain. Please tell me it's Tyler Bate, not Trent Seven. No, it's Trent Seven. Fuck. Okay.
The NXT North American title stole the show at its inaugural ladder match and has only become even more coveted in the years since its introduction.
Well, it's easy to see why, Michael. NXT has some of the fiercest competitors in the world, and hey, the title looks pretty cool, too.
Nice counter from Trent Seven. Great job refocusing to reverse that.
I'm going for the Universal Championship.
What? You haven't even won a mid-card title yet?
The game is... That's what it's giving me.
What the fuck? Okay.
I have a feeling that I'm not going to win it, though.
Why do you say that?
I don't know. I feel like it would be like a cutscene or something. I don't think it's going to... It's too early for me to win it.
Unless there's something that you just so happen to have enough fans to do it.
And it's not like I'm fast tracking. I've literally done every single thing that's been offered.
If this works, it could change the course of the match.
I mean, whatever works, I guess.
He has a task at hand, but prefers to be choked up high. Neck breaker all the way from the top. With a lariat.
On the middle rope.
Challenger is not in a great place. Not a bad place to be in, but the longer this goes, the more trouble a superstar exposes himself to. For the win! There's two! The champion retains! Here is your winner, and still NXT North American Champion, Chris.
First defense of the NXT North American title.
This is going to be good. The following contest. And here we have a superstar with a big chip on his shoulder.
He has certainly felt overlooked recently.
Well, he has a chance to change that perception in this matchup.
And if you want high-flying trouble, look no further than this man, Isaiah Swerve Scott. He's one of the most gifted, agile, and unpredictable competitors on the roster.
Yeah, and before Scott arrived in WWE, he tore up the indie scene and made a name for himself as a top talent. I assure you, he's out to replicate that success here against the best superstars in the world.
Shown on the exploder suplex. Oh, what a headbutt. The arm absorbing the damage.
And Swerve expected that.
Up the top, Buckles.
What's he got?
From the top, catches nothing but air. And that failed to hit the mark. Targeting the arm now. And Isaiah gets kept grounded in that hit. Swerve is getting beaten.
How long are you gonna stay up?
I don't know. I'll probably be up for a little while longer. What?
I'm just asking.
What's Swerve in for?
Oh, that'll make you bite your tongue off.
Swerve is down and out. Shoulders down. Two.
And he's still in the game.
I truly thought it was all over there. Talk about resilience.
Yeah, but did you see how the referee had to get into position? That was all the difference. I can't tell if it's anger in the...
From the middle rope.
Swerve is one step quick.
Oh, geez. Nasty kick.
kick to the face.
The advantage now is squarely in his corner.
Yeah, he's got to surmount this storm coming at him.
Superstar building and clear that just won't get it done.
And here comes the cover. Is it enough to...
Oh, hey, feet on the ropes.
Oh, good.
Great call by our official.
If the ref was more honest, there would be no need to cheat. Down with a suplex. He is truly feeling it right now, as well he should.
You can see as he rises how vulnerable of a position he's in.
Shining wizard.
That might have put the exclamation point on this one.
An impressive win here tonight, but don't forget he now has to face Keith Lee.
Before I get to my next match against Keith Lee, I have a few things I'd like to discuss. Hang on a second. Just let me gather my thoughts real quick.
Gather your thoughts or stall before you have to face a rested and motivated Keith Lee.
Okay, where was I? Like any top superstar would, I did my homework on Keith Lee in preparation for tonight's match. And I learned some very interesting things. See, this man is full of hashtags and motivational catchphrases, but it's all a bunch of lies. He's never lived up to a single one of them. Like, did you know that Keith Lee stole his parents' car when he was first leaving home to become a wrestler? I guess Grand Theft Auto is the true definition of limitless. Speaking of Keith's parents, turns out they didn't even want him to get into wrestling. They wanted him to continue playing football, but instead he quit, turning his back on his team and a free education that millions would die for. I doubt any of his coaches or teammates felt like basking in his glory after that. But after reading more and more about Keith Lee's backstory, one thing became clear. This is a pattern. He's always taking the easy way out, finding people who buy into his phony persona and enable him to receive countless opportunities after failing over and over again. Like, for instance, how he failed to make the cut at the Performance Center 3 times before he was bailed out by William Regal, who, to this day, continues to give him chance after chance when all he does is squander them. But this pattern really first started with Keith Lee's grandmother, who introduced him to wrestling as a young boy in Texas. While I can't go back and fix the giant mistake she made, I can put an end to it now. So Keith Lee, come on out here so I can expose you for what you really are. A fake, a liar, a failure, and soon to be
Wait a second.
Former WWE superstar.
Keith Lee, holy shit.
Talk about a man's family and grandmother, and this is what you get.
Keith Lee's on a rampage. He snapped. Someone needs to stop him. If anyone can talk some sense into Keith Lee, it's NXT General Manager William Regal.
And finally, it looks like cooler heads are prevailing.
He may have taken a beating, but I think this is what he wanted. He got inside Keith Lee's head, and now he has an important mental edge going into whatever their next encounter is.
Keith Lee is as tough mentally as he is physically. I'm not sure that strategy is going to work.
Did you not just see what happened? I think it's already proven extremely effective.
I hope going into the storyline, I didn't lose my NXT North American title.
I'm turning heel.
Did you win the Universal title?
No, it was a cutscene.
I really hope I didn't lose my title. I don't think so, but I'd be shocked if it took it away from me. Because I couldn't defend the title. It didn't give me an option.
I think it's fair to say the rivalry between Keith Lee and his opponent has quickly gone from heating up to boiling over as they square off tonight at the Performance Center.
Just holding the match here is another example of Lee's opponent attempting to get under the big man's skin. But tonight, Lee will be looking to put the big talker back in his place.
Easier said than done, Saxton. Keith Lee's opponent's been basking in Lee's head, and I don't see that stopping anytime soon. Had that one scouted.
Yikes. My goodness. Can barely keep up with all these strikes.
Oh, the elbow drop, knee crusher! And again,
nothing's gonna stop it.
Producing a trampling. The damage he's taken is starting to pile up. Lee falling victim to a surge of attacks here.
Lee needs to find an opening and fast. Climbing up top, he's got big plan.
Oh, look out.
Oh my God.
What a striking combination. Boom! Devastating kick.
Keith Lee gets out of the way.
Oh, and a wicked clothesline. Lee with a counter.
Keith looking to get back in this.
That could be the trigger for Lee to battle his way back. These consecutive attacks have him reeling. Yeah, this flurry's proven to be quite the challenge.
Here we go again.
Jawbreaker.
Lee's down. Lee may be out.
Oh, rocked him with that kick.
Snapmare.
Drop.
Ooh, nasty.
The close of this match is just ahead.
Here's a cover.
Come on. They can't win this way.
Yes, ref breaks the illegal pin.
An unrelenting attack here on Lee.
Surprising to see Lee get knocked around like this.
And the cover for the win.
Gotta wonder what his strategy is here, Cole.
Yeah. Oh, what a kick.
An elusive Keith Lee there. Snapmare.
Fist drop. Oh, and a wicked clothesline. He thinks he has it.
Must have something different in mind here. Wow. Ah.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, clothesline.
Lee looking unable to get a leg up in this match.
Keith Lee is at his limits.
This can't bode well.
Yeah. Impact on the jaw.
Meet him at the pay window.
Fights back.
Keith looking to get back in this.
Could be what Lee needed to ignite a rally.
Sharp elbows to the body, looking to fight his way out. And Keith Lee is being broken down.
Surprising to see Lee get knocked around like this.
Great reversal.
He weathered the storm and wants to create a flurry of his own.
Ooh. Keith Lee, look out! Ground zero!
This match is all Keith Lee.
Not even a two count! What unbelievable power!
What? What just...
I can't.
Agreed, Saxton. Looks like there's no limit to how much damage this superstar can absorb.
The look on Keith Lee's face told the story. A powerful maneuver
up high. He must have had that scouted.
And this has got to be it.
And the rope will force a break.
Oh, and a wicked clothesline.
Cover.
We're going to put this one away. Hooks the leg. Wait a minute. Using the ropes here for leverage.
Two.
And the ref spots the illegal use of the ropes. Had an answer for Lee.
Finds the advantage after a string of counters.
Oh, that hurt right to the kidney.
Golly.
He got whipped into that corner.
Good timing with that reversal.
Nailed it. Shining Wizard. Devastating.
Not so fast. Referee caught him in
Come on.
Breaks the count. He reverses it.
Ducking out of trouble.
Super kick.
Nope.
Yep.
Oh.
Shoulders down.
Cover.
Whoa, wait
a using
minute.
The ropes for leverage.
Two. Oh, come on. Plain as day, his feet were...
I gotta face Keith Lee in a fucking Extreme Rules match. I had a choice between Iron Man and some submission, but I knew for a fact I wasn't doing Iron Man.
Why?
I'm not gonna sit in a match for 15 minutes when I can beat him in 5.
This guy is ready for.
I'm gonna change my entrance soon, but I'm not gonna change anything until I get to the main roster.
The bell rings on the rematch as Keith Lee faces off against a superstar on a mission to break down the big man and make him quit NXT. It sure seems like Keith Lee's opponents found Lee's limit, Cole.
Keith Lee may not have been able to pick the match stipulation, but the Limitless One has never been afraid of an uphill battle. He said he won't give in or give up, and I believe him. He must have seen that coming.
String of attacks right now.
Able to evade. He foiled that attempt.
No, did we just see a tooth fly out?
That's gonna sting.
And this match will head back to the ring. He gets back into the ring.
Neck breaker.
In mind, take it from me. Nothing good ever comes from rearranging furniture.
He steps foot in the ring again.
Snapmare takeover.
Ooh,
nasty.
He's lost some of his wind now.
Just breaking down the opponent.
Lee avoids the attack.
A counter answered by another counter.
DDT! Lee falling victim to a surge of attacks here.
Lee needs to find an opening and fast.
And Lee turns the tables.
Could be what Lee needed to ignite a rally.
Another reversal. Eye for an eye here. Reversal on top of reversal. Both superstars showing great awareness of their opponent's repertoire.
DDT planted.
Looks like he has something planned with his table, guys.
I don't want to know.
He just isn't being given any room to recuperate.
Yeah, he has to devise some kind of new strategy here.
Well scattered reversal there.
Good chance for him to regain his wits.
Boosted flying. He's setting his table up, and guys, someone's about to have a really bad night.
Judo thrown into a DDT. Stomping down.
Lee looking unable to get a leg up in this match.
Keith Lee is at his limits. Overhead, belly to belly. A well-timed dodge.
Oh, God. You can't take much more of this.
Yeah, not looking good at all.
He's got a plan for that table, and it does not involve a dinner party.
Oh, shining wizard. Good night, Keith Lee.
Oh, my God.
Putting you through this table, Keith Lee. I don't care.
This ends right here.
Through the table. The opening is there for the table.
Two. It's over. All in a night's work.
Here is your winner, Chris.
Terminated, Keith Lee. Okay, I'm still NXT North American Champion. Whew. Okay, we're good. Okay, so I still have a bunch of... Okay. And what, how do I throw the opponent into the air? That's what I'd like to know. Because I don't know the button to throw my opponent in the air.
The following contest. This guy is the real. Introduced. When you land in NXT, few things seem as important as an opportunity for the North American title.
Few have held it, but many have battled over it. I expect this match to be nothing short of spectacular.
I've been waiting all night for this one.
And now there's an opening.
Pulls the ripcord. Penny predicament.
Still seems a little early.
Oh, foot just stomping down. Returning to the ring now. He's one step ahead there. Stops the kick.
Knee right to the face.
And Devlin reverses it.
Expected that one.
Great counter. Impressive ring IQ on display there. Down across the neck. The challenger's looking shaken.
He planned for this and could still rally.
Devlin dodges out of that.
Hits him with the counter. Oh, fucking clothesline.
Devlin shining with it. The champ has this one in hand now.
Two count.
Three. That's it. The champ stays the champ.
Here is your winner, and still NXT North America Champion, Chris Bannon.
I'm assuming there's got to be a gimmick. Like, there's going to be a storyline where we lose our titles. Because there's, like, no way we're going to go undefeated. Right? Like, there's got to be a storyline where we purposely lose it. Or is this literally going to be Here Comes the Pain mode, where we keep going until we lose our title?
A mystery opponent, you say?
I have no storylines left. What am I supposed to do?
Look at your social media or something.
There's nothing. I really don't want to turn face. It might force me to turn face.
I like how the crowd doesn't cheer at all for the heels. I just end their seats.
I'm gonna change my signatures and finishers again because I don't really like what I'm using. I like the clothesline from hell. I like that. I need to
Who's
find
his teammate?
I need to find the right move.
What? Shawn Michaels? Can you believe we're only 3 weeks away from WrestleMania?
Yeah.
It's kind of crazy.
Wait, is the dark matter in this game still? It is.
Bye.
I go with the regular TKO. I like the swinging TKO better. I don't know what move I want to do with my manager. Might go back to the spear.
I reversed that. I so reversed that. Whatever.
Oh, the big ending has a pinfall after it now.
Cool. I like how I hated that guy's guts and now I just his teammate. You work early or what?
Oh yeah.
That's why you
So I think I'm gonna have to turn face here. I don't think I have a choice.
The IC match now.
Crap, I don't wanna turn face right now. Oh, okay.
They are ready for battle. Tag team match underway. Bragging rights in the division are on the line.
Highly competitive tag team division in WWE. Winning this match will go a long way in separating yourselves from the pack.
Sharp elbows to the body, looking to fight his way out. Oh, caught in the chin. Oh, there's the old stump puller leg snap. Very effective. Kick lands. He saw it coming.
Don't be trying to run at me, boy.
Gross. He's looking a little off balance. What makes a great tag partner, Cole, is knowing when to tag. We'll find out soon enough if he's even a good tag partner. Double underhook suplex.
Well measured. Oh, what a kick. Devlin dodges out of that.
Turns that back on Devlin.
He is delivering elbow after elbow.
Suplex.
So apparently I failed the objective because I didn't let my opponent get any offense in.
Yeah, that's a thing.
What? Okay. So I have to let him hit me? Oh, it's because I beat him before the cutscene, that's why.
To it.
kicks in.
Clean tag for his partner.
The tag.
Snap for the takeover.
There's the kick.
He's absorbed some damage already.
And Finn was ready for that.
Getting him into the corner. Tag is registered.
Uppercut connects.
This could be over right here.
Got the sit up, and there's the powerbomb.
And finds a counter.
He steers clear of contact.
Deadly dot.
Up across the shoulders, and
there's a call. His victory in hand for Devlin.
Two. I do not know how they got up from that.
Operating on pure instinct and adrenaline. And it may just take going to the well one more time with that maneuver to gain the pinfall. Tossed into the corner. Counters with an attack on Devlin. Great wherewithal on the counter. What's he planning here? Point. Across the top rope, all the way. There's the cover.
One, two, three.
That's gotta feel good. Sweet, sweet victory. Here are your winners.
I guess I just turned face, even though I didn't want to. Massive disappointment.
Can I bother you for a selfie? I'd be so thankful. I asked Raul, man.
Oh, I forgot about the NXT Breakout Tournament. Oh, shit. I can always go back to that. You know it sucks?
Huh.
We can't win the tag titles in MyRise.
Mm-hmm.
I got my resiliency maxed out finally. Trying to get my grappling and strength striking up higher now so I can do more work. I think I might stop here though for the night.